Hello. Hello students. Today we are going to discuss about pressure groups in India. Pressure groups are organizations that want to influence the government to act in a certain way. They are the interest groups which work to secure certain interests by influencing the public policy. Pressure groups are also called advocacy group, lobby group, campaigning group, interest groups or special interest groups. Nature of pressure groups. Pressure groups represent diverse interests. Pressure groups are called as interest groups because of the interest that they represent. A interest is simply a concern shared by a large number of individuals. An interest group is nothing but an organization of individuals who share one or more interests and who try to influence decisions of the political system so as to promote their interests. That means pressure groups are their interested groups. They have the specific interest on the large number of individuals. That may be the political interest or personal interest or business interest. This is one of the examples of the interest groups or pressure groups. Unofficial instruments. Pressure groups are usually unofficial instrument of government that they are not mentioned in the constitution. Actually, that was not in the mention any in constitution. Pressure groups. Political parties are mentioned in the constitution, but the pressure group was not mentioned in the Indian constitution. They have the provisions because they have to right to make an association and unions. That is one of the importance of the making a association or unions or associations of the interest groups. So some of the temporary interest groups are temporary pressure groups. In India, the creations and dissolutions of pressure group is a common phenomenon. Many groups are created for a particular object and they lose their identity after achieving their objectives. We call it as ad hoc interesting groups or temporary groups. We call it as a temporary groups because some of the particular object, if they are achieved their objective, it automatically dissolve. It automatically dissolve and if they forget it about their interest because they have achieved a lot. So the pressure groups functions like a political parties. It worked as a political parties because how political parties worked on the basis of the particular agenda or particular ideologies. Pressure group also can same the work in nature as the political parties because it has a specific agendas. Pressure group has a specific agendas. Some pressure groups in India also function like political parties during the time of the election because election can influence the people mind. Because some of the voting, changes of the vote and the percentage of vote to the particular party, it influences through the pressure groups only. Pressure groups are flexible groups. Since the pressure groups in India have to function in a multi-party system, they keep on changing their political identities. They do not openly support or oppose any political party. So they are flexible group because they have not, rigid in the nature, but that flexible in nature because it cannot support openly or oppose any political party because it must take a very, very interesting manner of the every political parties are very important to the pressure groups because they have to achieve their ideas through the political parties. So those who are came to power in the government or central or state government, that is what they do not openly support and even oppose any political parties. Even pressure groups are not ideologically oriented. The pressure groups in India are not ideologically oriented. During some circumstances, these groups create law and order problems and instabilities, agitations, threat, gherav, protest and violent methods are supported by these groups. Therefore, these groups are called as violent organization because they have no ideological oriented. So through the agitations, gherav or some of the threat and through the violent methods, so considered as the violent organization. They are also referred as anomic groups. So some of the groupism and even a selfishness matter in the pressure groups. These groups cannot hold independent position in politics. Groupism and selfishness of the leaders are responsible for this. So the political parties find it difficult to direct and control these pressure groups. Because no one politician can control this groupism and even a selfishness because there is no particular grip on the pressure groups or interest groups. That is what even it is very difficult to direct and control these pressure groups. Types of the pressure groups. Pressure groups are present in all the countries. They include business pressure groups, labor pressure groups, cooperatives, pressure groups, agricultural pressure groups, industry, and these professional groups. So business groups. So these exercise tremendous pressures on government, on legislator and administrator. They liberally give donation to political parties, because every political parties have some groups of the businessmen, because of they are expecting some of the donation to the growing of the political parties. So political parties, various public funds, charitable trust institutions invite ministers to inaugurate or to preside over various functions. They also make friendship with people in power. They oblige political leaders and administrators by employing their man in various form. They use various means to influence the policy and the laws of government. Example, the first example, Federation of Indian Chamber of Commerce and Industry, we call it as, in a form, FICCI, Indian Manufacturer Organization, then Association of Chairman of Commerce. Some of the associations considered as the business pressure groups. Trade and unions or labor organization. Trade unions exert a lot of influence over the government in orders to protect the interest of the empowerment of the service conditions of the workers. However, there are large member of trade unions in India. They are not united. Some of them are even hostile to one another. They are All India Trade Union Congress, ITAC, Hindu Mazdoor Sabha, then Central Indian Trade Union, C2. These trade unions are attached to different political parties, like ITAC is attached to the Communist Party in India, C2 is attached to the CPM, Communist Party of Marxism, and so on. Agrarian on Peasant Organization. Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel had organized the peasant under the Indian National Congress, known as the All India Kisan Congress. This group fight for the protection of their interests, such as implementation of land reforms, decentralization of powers, loan, stabilization of prices of agricultural products and the life. They influence the government in their favor. Similarly, Hind Kisan Panchayats of the Socialist, United Kisan Sabha of the Marxist, etc. Religious or cultural organization or religious interest groups. These groups seek to protect the interest of their respective communities. Religious and cultural organization or follows Anglo-Indian Christian Association, Catholic Bishops Group, Conference of India, etc. Some of the caste organization and even a tribal organization identify as a pressure groups in India to protect the interest of the tribals. There are Jharkhand party in Bihar and Orissa, because Bihar and Orissa, some of the hill stations, the whole state or even the some of the government controlled by the tribal organization. Naga National Conventions, Tribal Sangha of Assam, Tribal League of Assam, United Mizo Federation Organization, etc. And even some of the caste organization working as a pressure groups or interest groups in India. The following are the caste organization in India: Scheduled Caste Federations, Gujarat Kshatriya Sabha, Dravida Munnetra Kazagam, Vakkaliga Association, Lingayat Association, etc. These organizations protect the interest of their caste through various means. So different manner and the different interest of the caste, religious, tribals and business groups and some of the labor groups are working for their people, because they have not a specific ideologies, but they have the interest and protect the interest of their own people. That is what it is, one of the factor of the regionalism concept. And even the pressure groups have not a specific ideological concerns, and even it is not a political parties. Thank you.